Does your printer sometimes get a certain distance up a print and then fail like this? Or maybe it prints, but then when it's finished it looks like this? I'm about to show you why this normally happens, and of course I'm going to show you how to fix it. As always, with 3D printing issues, there's multiple reasons why you might get a single symptom. In fact, I have an upcoming video on how important a proper diagnostic process is when it comes to 3D printing issues. But this particular issue is such a telltale sign of a single common problem that I thought it was worth sharing as its own special video. What normally happens is that the first few dozen layers or so will print perfectly, and then a couple of centimeters up, or maybe more, that's where the trouble starts. This, in case you didn't know, is underextrusion. Too little material is coming out of the nozzle, and it's most often caused by a block nozzle when it happens like this. But it's just a symptom that you see, part of a chain of events that's happening that leads to the block nozzle. I'm not here to waste your time, so here's why it's happening. This is the chain of events. Stay watching though if you can, because you'll see some cool demonstrations of what's going on in a bit more context. Usually what's going on here is that you're printing a bit on the fast side. You might not be, but either way you're probably having a fair bit of filament flowing through the nozzle for one reason or another. This of course is removing the thermal energy from the nozzle and the hot end. It may not show up on the temperature readings on the thermistor because that's in a different part of the heat block. Now down low close to the bed you're getting thermal energy from the heated bed for free, so you may get away with it. But the further you get away from the heated bed, the less that extra heat is helping you. So eventually you're going to reach a tipping point, where the temperature of the filament in the hot end is dipping down just too much, and that's where you're in partial blockage territory. And it might even resolve itself and carry on, and it often does. Maybe spontaneously, or maybe when it just gets to a different shaped layer. Some really weird things can happen when we're just on the boundary of a block nozzle. You might or might not get clicking from the extruder. It depends on the extent and the length of the blockage, and also how good a grip your extruder has on the filament in the first place. My Mini Deltas rarely click when under extruding. But the noise is the first sign I get of a problem on the Ender 3 V2. But it does depend on the filament as well. For example, a soft filament like TPU is unlikely to cause clicking on any extruder. Through the magic of colour changing PLA, I can show you how far the heat propagates up from the bed. This bed is at 50 degrees C. Looking at the failed part under the microscope, you can see that there's really almost no layer-to-layer adhesion at all at the failed point. This is fairly disastrous in terms of strength, especially if you are printing vase mode or vase mode, where it's likely the piece will just fall apart. So, as you might have gathered by now, the solution is pretty simple once you've identified the cause. I actually suggest making special profiles for fast printing. Set the temperature to 5 or 10 degrees hotter than usual when you're in a draft or fast mode. You can do this in Cura by just changing the print temperature and saving a profile. In Prusa Slicer you have to have a separate filament profile, but it's essentially the same, it's just another thing to remember to change when you change profile. Bear in mind that also, in my experience, as PLA ages and is left out, it seems like it needs to be printed at higher temperatures. So a reel that might have printed fine at 200 degrees C a month ago might now need 210 degrees C to get the same results. And of course you could be printing so low in the first place that you could have these recognisable signs even from the start of the print. And obviously this is not the only cause of underextrusion, it's just that if you start seeing underextrusion at the same kind of point in each print, then this is the first thing you should be looking for. If you want to know what temperature I use for PLA, well, I used to print at 195 degrees C, but I think formulas have changed over the years, so I now recommend printing at a minimum of 200 degrees C. And for printing fast, for example 60 millimeters per second on a larger part, I recommend going up to around 215 degrees C. Well, I hope that helps a bit to avoid this particularly frustrating mid-print ruining phenomenon. If you found this useful, I have way more of this kind of stuff coming up, and I already have videos on this kind of thing. It's sort of what I do, so please subscribe. Otherwise, thank you for watching.